welcome back to the Creeping Fig Cottage Kitchen. As promised, this episode we are making blancmange. Simply translated, that is white food. That's exactly what it is. Simple, all white ingredients, surprisingly delicious. It has a really cool history. It's an extremely old recipe, found back as early as the 13th century. A lot of the recipes originated more in the 16th century. It is essentially medieval European dessert. It can be flavored and colored any way you like, but at its base, I think it's really impressive for being so simple, so that is what we're gonna make today. We are going to start with a third cup of sugar. To that, we will be adding 3 tablespoons of cornstarch. The interesting thing about blancmange is that it is a molded, served cold, molded, but it has no gelatin. So I find it to be really interesting that it stands on its own with no gelatin. We are going to add a pinch of salt. Any good cook knows a pinch of salt goes a long way. All right, so we're gonna mix that together. We have sugar, cornstarch, pinch of salt. We are going to now pour in 2.5 cups of, I'm using whole milk. It was made with almond milk, actually, in medieval, go figure, almond milk's been around a long time. Almond milk could definitely be used. So stirring in our 2.5 cups of milk. Essentially, we are done. We are going to move this over to the stove and thicken it up. Once it starts to thicken, the recipe says you're gonna wanna cook it for about 2 or 3 more minutes. And I actually set a timer for this to make sure I don't overcook it. As you can see, our blancmange is nice and thick, which is amazing. It only took, I'd say it takes about 5 minutes to get it to this place. Now, after it's thickened, we are going to add 1.5 teaspoons of vanilla. To that, I have added about 1/4 teaspoon of almond extract because it's a nod to its original recipe, which was almond-based. It really has a very subtle vanilla-y flavor that you can add anything to. There was a recipe from European, medieval Europe, with saffron that sounded really great to me. So once you get that vanilla and our almond extract nice and stirred in, we are actually going to pour this into a vintage jello mold that I picked up at an estate sale that I think is gonna be really impressive when we unmold it. So let's dump this into our mold. I'm actually going to let this sit out at room temperature because it's really hot and it needs to go into the refrigerator to cool down, but I'm going to let it sit, get a little less hot before I stick it in the fridge to set up. I like to bang it a couple times to get any really big air bubbles out, because that is the enemy of a beautifully unmolded dessert, big air bubbles. Thanks to the magic of YouTube, you are not gonna have to wait the few hours. I actually cooked some up for you beforehand. And here we have it, blancmange. I decided to put them in a vintage sherbet bowl or serving dessert bowl, whatever you have. These are made to be individually served. I imagine you could serve them like this. They are delicious. You could top them with a jam or a jelly or preserve. You could top them with chocolate ganache. They really are a beautiful blank canvas. Now we will send some out to the Mayhew boys for a taste test.
Okay, I like it. It's kind of like rice pudding without rice.
To me, it tastes like vanilla ice cream.
It kind of does have a vanilla ice creamy vibe.